undisputed WWE Universal Champion.
So, what do you guys want to talk about? I think it goes without saying, but every week there's someone new watching this show, so I'll go ahead and say it. I am not the same person I was when I started this journey over 15 years ago on this very show. I've thought a lot, though, about 19-year-old me. First day on the job, pulling up to this metal barn, Ohio Valley Wrestling. There's a sign on the door that says, Tomorrow's Superstars Today. And I'm sitting in my beater Volkswagen Jetta, and I'm about to go inside. And I remember, I vividly thought to myself, I'm gonna be WWE champion within inside of 2 years. Hey, I was ambitious, albeit a little bit delusional, because I also thought, I'm gonna be the next John Cena. All right, so if I could go back, if I could talk to 19-year-old me, if I could write him a letter, what would I say? What would it say? Would I tell him? I don't think it's gonna go down like that, Chief. Would I tell him that one night in London you're gonna get slapped so hard on live TV that your knees buckle? Would I tell him that you're gonna be dashing Cody Rhodes and you're gonna give out grooming tips? Would I tell him that you're gonna win the Intercontinental Championship and restore it to its former retro glory? Would I tell him that you're gonna paint your face and become less than, that triumph will become tragedy, will become triumph all over again? Would I tell him the woman on the outside of the ring who has been saying everyone's names all night, that ends up becoming your wife? Would I tell him that you're gonna lose a 295-pound best friend, but you're gonna gain a 6-pound one back who has his same eyes? Would I tell him that you're gonna be on fire at one point, that you're gonna bleed all over the world? Would I tell him in 2015, you do what everybody tells you not to do? You take an excursion, and part of that excursion is fully focusing on the industry's health, and I ended up neglecting my own. Would I tell him that on January 28th, 2023, at the Royal Rumble, you outlasted 29 others and you punched a ticket? You punched a ticket, the very first in your family to punch this ticket, to go on last under the brightest lights on the biggest damn stage at WrestleMania. Guys, truth be told, I wouldn't tell him a single thing. I wouldn't tell him a single thing because every little piece on this broken road, every splinter on this upwards ladder has been unequivocally 100% worth it. Now I come out here tonight and I hear some of you singing the words to Kingdom. That's my song. It has gone everywhere with me. It will continue to do so. But the first words on that track are my own. And that is where I say, wrestling has more than one royal family. Actually, WWE has more than one royal family. But for that to be true, for it to be real, for it to be venerated, validated, and vindicated in my heart, I have to stand across from another. I have to stand across from an entire bloodline. I have to stand across from the tribal chief, the head of the table. I have to stand across from essentially the LeBron James of this generation of superstars and wrestlers, the biggest superstar on the planet, a man who has had the title for 800 and something days. I have to stand across from Roman Reigns. I'm sure you can hear it. I have a great deal of respect for Roman, and I am talking sincerely, but what I say next, I say with the same sincerity. WrestleMania is in 62 days. Roman, that might just be 62 days for you. It is 62 days for the rest of my life. At WrestleMania, undesirable has already become undeniable, but undeniable remains uncrowned, and on that night, it ends. At WrestleMania, pull up a chair, sit wherever the hell you want. On that night, somebody else is going to be eating. And after WrestleMania, you can be the tribal chief, you can be the head of the table, you can be the biggest superstar in the world, but the one thing that Roman Reigns will not be is the WWE Undisputed Universal Champion.
The mission statement is clear. Cody Rhodes, highly motivated on his road to WrestleMania.